We will never need vengeance. I play around. No, I've never needed it. I know nothing. Look, I tell you right now, I couldn't even tell you when I would need vengeance. You know what I mean? I couldn't tell you. I'll never need it. This team's strong enough to kick everything's ass.
I'm sorry.
In this game. It's not like I don't want to use it or something, because I'm used to, like, people always say, oh, people who aren't any good at using vengeance or something don't know how to be low on health with characters. And I have plenty of experience with low health characters on Fire Emblem. Ask anybody who's played New Mystery and Lunatic. They can tell you that you're getting through that game mostly with everyone on fucking 1 HP. So I know how to manage, like, you know, low health characters, because I've played games that require it. But, like, you know, because vengeance is part of the meta, I like going against it. I like going against the meta. You know what I mean? Like, we don't need Battalion Wrath. I don't like it. We don't need this vengeance that everyone says is what makes people S tier. I just like going against the meta. I don't know, I've got fucking Manuela sitting about here, dude. I don't care about any fucking metas, do you know what I mean? But, like, that's just because we're building her to be fun, though. It's like, I don't know. There is different playstyles in this game, with, like, whether you want to look at them as being... No playstyle is lazy, but there's, like... So, like, Radiant Dawn is quite a different kind of game in terms of, I guess Radiant Dawn, right? Radiant Dawn is, how to say? Radiant Dawn's a prime example of, like, how I would classify a certain playstyle. It's like, you know, this game's all about building characters, right? That's why they have all these weapon ranks. Everybody can become everything, everybody can have all these weapon ranks. That is exactly why people who like Radiant Dawn won't like this kind of game as much. Because you don't have to do anything in, like, games like Radiant Dawn. Like, people are just okay by default or whatever, you know? Like, how, that's why Ike and Har and all that are so broken. All these characters are so busted. And actually, as much as I like Radiant Dawn, there's some stuff about that that's not as fun. Because that is well different than other games, too. Because, like, you don't need to do anything in Radiant Dawn. You never really need to care about working on a weapon rank or any of that shit at all. Because everyone's already what they are. You know, and it's like something can be taken away for that as well, for people who like building up characters and that. As much as I like Radiant Dawn, though, because I see the good in that game as being in the turn counts of the levels, so it's a different kind of gameplay, you know. It's the same with like New Mystery is another example, I think, where that's a good game where I like managing weapon ranks on, oh, can I chip this guy for an extra bit of lance rank so I can wield a javelin? Completely different kind of weapon ranking, you know, and building characters in that game. A good way of it. But I don't think Radiant Dawn is a fun game for building characters. It doesn't even exist. You know what I mean? Nothing. There's nothing about Radiant Dawn that exists about building any sort of unit, because they're already pre-built. You know what I mean? And as good as that is, because, like, the gameplay comes from the turn counts. You know what I mean? At least for me. So there's always the Fire Emblems are always fun in some regard. And I it's like, what I like about this one, I'm building an army. You know what I mean? It's like, I don't want to play this game like Radiant Dawn. You know what I mean? I don't want to play this game like Radiant Dawn because I don't need to. I want to play Radiant Dawn like Radiant Dawn. I want to play New Mystery like New Mystery. I want to play Three Houses like we are playing an RPG. Kinda, because we are. You know? It's all that stuff. You know? That's why I hate this skip this level. Do this, do that. If you can't be bored doing it, just give her vengeance. It's all the things that would make well in a Radiant Dawn type game that you would use 9 out of 10 times because you have to. You know? I like building characters in this game to be somewhat capable. You know? And I've got no problem with playing with characters on low health and all that, because I've played plenty of games where we need to be on low health. You know? It's... All of them are different for their own different things, I think. You know? Not to say that I think anybody's playing wrong or something by just skipping levels or doing whatever you want. It's the way it is. Like, if you want to save, do a one turn on a level here and there and all that, like, it's cool, but, like, what's it getting you other than making your team shitter if you skip the early levels, especially? Because, like, you'll be losing XP that will help you win, you know? But like, you know, there's loads of ways of looking at it, eh? But I don't see this game as like any sort of turn count game or, you know, anything like that. Nothing, not really. But like, if every game was just level to level like Radiant Dawn, then it'd have to be made like Radiant Dawn, where every character's OP as fuck in like the Dawn and like, what's it, Ike's team, what is it, the Grail Mercs. Because they are, you know? The only time you get a bit of team building in Radiant Dawn is in the beginning. As much as people shit on the Dawn Brigade, and that's exactly why they shit on the Dawn Brigade, is because they are shit, and you need to build them up to be somewhat decent. And people can't wait to get rid of them. You know what I mean? Because, oh, I'd just rather play as the Grail Mercs who are OP by default. You know? It's a bit boring too. Let's not just fucking... You know Radiant Dawn's one of the worst selling games in the series, right? It's like... You know, so let's just calm down there. It's like one of the worst games in the series, no matter how good it is in terms of like, I think it's the worst selling games in the series. I would maybe go that far. So I don't think people like that kind of gameplay as well, even though I like it for what it done. But I really like level to level games, but let's just, I don't know if I like the way Radiant Dawn does it as much because the characters are busted by default and I hate broken units by default. I don't find that fun in the games. You know what I mean? I don't like it. I don't like getting someone like Har being busted by default. Because all we need... It's a joke, man, with characters like Har and like, you know, Ike. They're just... They're laughing at their own games with how busted they are. But you need them if you want to do the turn counts. So that's like a different thing. But like Conquest, another one, that's not a level-to-level game. You do have the My Castle thing, and you can still treat it like a level-to-level game, but you still have to do a bit of micromanaging. You need to buy a javelin, you need to buy like a silver, you know, you need to do all those things. So as much as people say I like the level-to-level, the Conquest, they're not really doing level-to-level, because they still have to buy heal staffs, men staffs, javelins, all this stuff. You know what I mean? It's like... It doesn't tilt me talking about vengeance. It really doesn't. I didn't get tilted. No such thing. I don't get tilted by vengeance. I think it's great that people need something like that to, you know, that is there for people who want to use it, like everything in these games. But I hate that something like vengeance is like, you need this. You need this to beat the game. You know what I mean? So, like, what are people talking about? Do you know what I'm... That's what gets me about it. Well, you need that to beat the game. You need hit plus 20 to beat... I feel exactly the same about hit plus 20. Like, I like getting hit plus 20 on the odd unit here and there. But we didn't need it to beat the fucking game. You know what I mean? We didn't need Yuritsa to beat the fucking game. You know, it's like that. It's like that. We don't need it. We don't need all these things, even though they're, like what you're saying, tools in the toolbox. But, like, people like Yuritsa take away from Crimson Flower. If we're talking about a strategy game, the tactics, Yuritsa takes away for that route just by being there. Yeah, like it doesn't feel like maddening anymore with him there. So let's, you know what I'm saying? It's like there's these little things that are a bit too far for a tactics game, at least for me. We already have too much one shots in the game to just have another one or whatever. It's like, I don't know. I just feel the same way about vengeance that I do with things like hit plus 20 and that. We just, the last run we done on Crimson Flower for YouTube, we done it with two abilities. We didn't do any recruiting. We had no adjutants. We went from level to level. We done like no paralogues apart for the ones in the group. It was about as straight as you can get it. And like, we didn't need hit plus 20 and we still beat the game. That's what I mean. So it's bullshit. We didn't use vengeance as well. So like things like that, you know, I like doing things against it, I guess. It's not like, just like going against the meta. Does that make sense? Because like, there's people that determine the meta of these games. I don't think we should always do what they say. I think that's there for people who really struggle at these games though. So like, they've got all this advice to take from them. You know? Which is fine. But I don't think it's advice. Hear me out here. I don't think it's advice telling people to skip levels. People that are new to Maddening and all that stuff. I don't think it's good advice. You know, I think it's better advice telling them how to build a team rather than relying on one character to get them by a level or something. You know, I kind of go against snipers. I don't really like snipers. They're a bit boring. You know, I honestly think that there's things in the game that are boring, and I think Sniper is one of them for me. Because all you're doing is just Hunter's Volleying, you know what I mean? And I just get a bit bored of it. So, like, there's some classes that I just don't like playing, and Sniper is one of them. You know, I think War Master's another, because I just get bored. I prefer things with Canto. I always have. At least that's what I've found out in the games, is I prefer things that have better gameplay elements, like Canto, Super Canto, being able to go in, kill something, and Canto back into safety rather than just going in and using a combat art and that's that. It's just me, though. It's just a personal thing.